matter of immense pleasure, as the resource person of today's webinar is one of the alumni of our college and an inspiration to all of us. I wholeheartedly welcome Ms. Neha Bhatnagar. She started her career by acquiring BCA degree from Biyani Girls College, then went on to be a graduate in sports management. She has work experience in the field of project management and marketing before joining Sporjo as an associate brand marketing and product. She worked with World Sports Travels in the capacity of head of marketing. IMG Reliance Foundation as assistant high performance manager, KPMG, and was the state ambassador for Rajasthan State Finance Commission. She worked on various projects and research assignments such as Pro Kabaddi League, Tata Mumbai Marathon, BCCI case study, FICCI research, economics of sports, to name a few. Without taking any time further, I welcome Ms. Neha Bhatnagar to enlighten us on the topic of sports management and career opportunities in that. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Chanvi, and thank you so much, everyone. I can see my teachers here, so very good morning to Devika ma'am, Anju ma'am, Poonam ma'am. It's a pleasure to be back, and I'd like to start. So I'm just going to share my screen. Let me know if you can see it. Is the screen visible?
Yes, Neha, we can see it.
Okay. So, as you know, today's topic is careers in sports. First of all, let's just keep this a little interactive. Do you guys know that there is a career in sports? Like, you can work in sports apart from being an athlete. Did you guys know it? You can just unmute and answer. Anyway, playing, but is my voice clearly audible?
You're not very audible somehow.
Give me a second.
Maybe you can use your earphones.
Yeah, just give me a second. So Sporjo was born out of the idea that anybody coming from outside the industry should have access to the industry, should know, you know, if nothing like this exists, in the whole world, this is world's first company which actually assesses people, consults, trains and plays them in the sports industry. So for example, if you go to you know, a trainer and you say, you know, I run really fast, so what will the trainer do? The trainer is going to ask you to run, you know, show me, do the run, and then that's where your assessment is done. So when you come to Sporjo, we assess you on the basis of your passion, proficiency, and personality. And then we tell you, you know, this is the right vertical for you to pursue your career in. Vertical, sales, sponsorship, marketing, grassroots, etc. Then after your coach has assessed you, then he consults you like, okay, this is where you went wrong. This is your path forward. So consulting comes exactly like that you, now you have your report in hand, now you get consultation that, you know, this is the way forward for you. Then the coach will train you hard. He will directly not put you in the Indian team, he will train you. So similarly, we train people in sports management in terms, you study, you know you attend a lot of master classes, you work on live projects from the industry, and you know, your reports are given, feedback is given to you. Then ultimately, your selection comes, like your team selection comes. Similarly here, your placements come. So you can apply for all the jobs, you can apply for all the interviews, you can apply for all the internships. So that's how the Sporjo process works. The mission is transforming passion to become a profession in sports. You do not have to kill your passion just because there are no jobs. There are jobs. It's just that the awareness is not there. The vision, as I said earlier, is to create an ecosystem of 500,000 people to support the Indian sports industry by 2030. Obviously, the values are be the change that you want to see in people all in the world. So this is something what candidates do, as already told you. Passion equals to job in sports? No, it doesn't work like that. If you have only passion, it won't. You probably watch a lot of sports, but your passion, your personality, and your proficiency, all three of these things matter. There is no clarity and expectations, on the roles, limited understanding. But similarly is with employers. There is no job mapping at the moment. You will find certain jobs here and there on Naukri or on Monster, other places. But there's no one place where you'll find jobs for sports. There is a long lead time. Now, lead time is when I want to hire somebody and I have to contact people that, is there anybody who know this thing? Is there anybody who like this thing? So there's a hiring. The hiring time becomes really, really big because their work is happening on the basis of reference or networking, etc. Reaching the right candidate is very, very difficult because of the limited talent pool and the limited amount of awareness present of the industry. That's where we come in. We provide jobs on our pages. We provide a database for companies to search their candidates in. It's an automated process. Limited training time for the companies. If a company is hiring someone and they have to, if someone is hired for 6 months, suppose there is an internship and you're learning for 3 months and then you started working, then the company is missing out on those 3 months while they train you. Now, if they train you and you shift to another job, then again, there's a company's loss. So we train people at Spojo and then they are hired by the employers. This is a Spojo process. You register, assessment, consulting, training module. This is how the report looks like. And we have our consultants. There are a lot of people we have placed up till now. And I think it's better if now I just take the questions. Whatever questions you have about the industry. Share your entire screen and flip. Oh. Sorry, ma'am. Was the screen not visible? Come on. Janvi. Devika ma'am, are you there?
Yeah, Neha, I'm there. Are there any people who would like to ask questions? You can please write in the chat box.
No, whatever questions you have, you can...
Neha, I have a question probably from the student side. Like once they have done their MBA, so as you're talking about the super specialization category of sports management, what are the premier institutes according to you wherein they can do the super specialization in sports management?
So we have a lot of institutes in India and abroad to do sports management. Namely, in India, we have ISM, GISD. IIM Rohtak has also started. You can see the intensity with which sports is growing, that IIM has, you know, stepped into the picture. But when you think about working in sports, it's not really necessary to have a degree in sports. So it's mostly like you need to have... it's mostly that you need to have the right kind of experience and right kind of knowledge. It is not necessary for you to have a degree to work in sports, or specialization can be done with the help of master classes, with the help of, certain short-term courses. And so I'd say there are institutes and then there is Spojo. So two platforms, pick and choose your favorite. When you talk about, you know, learning about sports marketing, there you need to learn, there is no specific curriculum, there is no point system that, you know, this is what you need to learn. You need to learn out of someone who has experienced all of it. So when you come to a company like Spojo, or a company who provides with that sort of experience, so we call it Sport Prep. And those are training modules, those are master classes that people take in sports sponsorship or sports marketing, and you learn what you require to learn. And then you just jump to an industry project wherein you will apply that knowledge directly, and it's a live project. It's not, like we have a project from a company wherein the person is working on digital content. Of the digital strategy of the company. They're constantly in touch with the company. And, then from that point onwards, your networking also starts in the industry. So all of these factors combined together gives you the experience where you can build a career in sports.
Right. And what are the key skills, according to you, for a student to be in the sports management field? Are there any specific skills apart from the management skills which are required in general?
Understanding of sports would be a good one to have.
Okay.
But just come from, an open mind that this is an industry where there are jobs. And if you have the management skills, then you're going to be working in the management, back end anyway. So that's a plus.
Right.
You know me, I come from IT background. The skills that I've acquired of communication, of anything, that has happened from Biani. So it's more like the same. I don't play, as I mentioned in the webinar also, I'm not an active sports player. But do I understand sports?
Right.
Yes. Do I like the industry, the business of sports? Yes. So if I can do it, anyone can make a career in sports. It's not...
Okay, any other questions? Somebody is asking, I think Sayukta Sharma is asking one question.
I'll read the question.
Take it. Yeah.
Yeah, so it's compulsory to be physically fit to go to any field of sports. So Sayukta, it is not compulsory to be physically fit, but I'd urge you to be physically fit. But what do you mean here by physically fit? Like, you need to be a gym-going person? Not at all. Can you just unmute and say, what do you mean by physically fit? Look, I'm having flat feet. Oh, I do have flat feet. That's common between the two of us. So no, you don't need to be physically fit. Your brain is at work. You're managing things. You can do so much. You can do literally so much. You will not be running on the field. You will not be going to the track and field and doing the 100 meter, 400 meters. So that's not a requirement.
Maybe she's trying to ask people who are physically challenged or certain ways. Are they fit to be in this industry too?
Absolutely, they are. Now we have the people who are physically challenged. We have teams. We have the Indian blind cricket team, we have, you know, the Paralympics that are in place. So when people who can play, definitely people can work at the back end. Definitely.
True. We have Paralympics also for that.
We have Paralympics.
Right.
So definitely. There's a lot of scope, and just like any other industry, no problem, Sayoka. Just like any other industry where, you know, people, all of them have a certain space, and all of them comes with a certain, you know, mindset and a skill that every individual has a skill that is very, very original to them. And that can definitely be put to use. There's no question about it.
And as you talked about Sorjo, I was thinking, can you share the brochure with us, some e-brochure, so that I can distribute it to the students, whosoever are interested in sports management field?
I surely can do that. For the interested students, we are doing a summer program, which is going to start on 17th of May. It's going to be a month-long workshop. We are covering 8 verticals. So I can just share and show you guys, actually. Is my screen visible?
Yes, it is. It is.
So we are doing a sports management workshop from the 17th of May, which will include 8 topics in sports management, 3 soft skill lectures. You'll be given 8 assignments, out of which 4 will be mandatory. And there'll be a leadership talk by an industry expert and a final presentation by you guys to the industry expert. We are covering topics like digital and social media, athlete representation, which is a very, very big field in India at the moment and across the world. We're covering sales and sponsorship, operations, data analytics, broadcast, esports. I'm not sure how many of you know about esports and how many of you play Valorant or, you know, Dota, PUBG and all. We have PUBG leagues in which India participates on World Forum. So that's also the academies and grassroots is a big. We always hear, you know, there is this academy, we need people to manage those academies as well. We have soft skill and, you know, mindfulness, because that's important. So the course will be of 30 days. It's going to be 1 or 1.5 hour duration a day. And it's 6:30 p.m. at night. But the best part about the course is the faculty. So we have Mr. G. Srinivasan, who is the current CEO of Sporjo. And he has been, you know, he was the head of Reliance Sports. He worked with BCCI and Nike and ESPN. He'll be taking the sponsorship and sales part. Then we have Mr. Avirul Johri, who has worked with the Commonwealth Bank of Australia, etc. He'll be taking the soft skill part. Of Kanika Sethi, she is an operations person. So remote control is to ma'am, should I approve this? Hi.
Maybe you are object last away. MC for them.
Sorry?
Okay. Neha, I think most of the questions you have already taken care of the students. I think you have given a comprehensive presentation about sports management. So I think it will be really helpful for most of the students to, you know, think about a new career, a new field of management. And definitely the students are going to, you know, it will open their minds and give them a newer perspective about the different fields of management, instead of just going for the most of the, you know, the common fields like HR or marketing or for that matter.
Common fields are now simple saturated. Corporate.
Yeah, exactly. These fields are already saturated. So we need to, you know, drift towards the newer perspectives, and this definitely has given the students a newer perspective to understand in a new way. So thank you so much, Neha, for taking out time from your busy schedule and letting our students gather knowledge about the newer things and a newer field. And definitely the interested students can contact me, or probably you can, you know, leave your email ID with us. I will be distributing it with the students. Whosoever wants to, you know, make a career in sports management, they can definitely go ahead. We are always there to help them out. And Neha ma'am is also there to help you out with whatever questions you have, or whatever way you want her to help you out. So thank you so much, Neha, once again for being with us and sparing your time and sharing this immense knowledge. I would also like to thank all the faculty members and the students who have joined us and helped us make this webinar a success. Thank you so much. I think this is the time to split because we already have a class now.
Yep. Thank you so much from my side as well to all the teachers. I heard names of all my IT teachers, and you meeting you is always a pleasure. So it was nice to come back. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you. Thank you so much. I think we can split now.
Yeah.